lot of people, you know, we really don't know what's going to happen with Donald Trump. You know, there's been a lot of allegation that, you know, Donald Trump might be even be assassinated. You know, the people are kind of like really don't want him to be the president of America because, you know what happened. Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Mary Star, and of course today I'm going to be talking politics, and there's been a lot of drama happening with Donald Trump, and I'm sure by now all of you have heard about the Showergate scandal that's going on right now. And this has kind of like really caused a lot of controversy, and there's been a lot of tantrums being thrown everywhere, and of course a lot of media networks have really felt the, you know, the humiliation of being exposed that, you know, providing fake news to the public. And just in case you missed it and you don't know what the, you know, the Golden Shower get is, just recently there were rumors going around that when Donald Trump was in Russia, he kind of like hired prostitutes to go to his hotel and piss on his bed. I think this is one of his one of his secret dirty secrets that he's keeping. And these of course are just allegations. I want to kind of like let you guys know that these were reports that were published without any verification on the truth of the whole scandal that kind of like unveiled from nowhere. So what happened, people are alleging that when Donald Trump was in Russia some time back, he was living at the Ritz Hotel, and this is one of the posh hotels. You know, if you're one of those people, you know, the Ritz are really renowned to be like really good hotels. If you're one of those, you know, people who have got lots of money, you might find yourself living in this hotel. And of course, I would recommend them because they're really, really nice, expensive hotels, better than Trump hotels, of course. And apparently when Donald Trump was in Russia, he kind of like asked for prostitutes to go to his hotel and piss on his bed. And of course the problem, what is so funny, is that the same hotel that he asked these prostitutes to piss on the bed is where Michelle and Obama once lived in it. And this was one of these maybe fantasies of Donald Trump, that he decided to order, you know, prostitutes to do that, to kind of like maybe defile Michelle Obama and, you know, husband. I don't know, these are just allegations, but the whole story is kind of like really, really funny because it's kind of like, it was embarrassing of course for Donald Trump. And a lot of people, you know, we really don't know what's going to happen with Donald Trump. You know, there's been a lot of allegation that, you know, Donald Trump might be even be assassinated. You know, the people are kind of like really don't want him to be the president of America because, you know what happened. Most people, actually Americans, when they were voting, they didn't have much choice to choose who's going to be their president. They didn't have really ideal candidates. And, you know, being one of those people who was following the political situation in America, I was kind of like thinking, oh, this must be really hard for the Americans, because to be honest, it was Trump and Hillary Clinton, and Hillary Clinton is for the establishment, and a lot of people really didn't like her. But anyway, Trump won, so now we have to deal with Trump. There's been kind of like a lot of dirty game playing going on. First of all, they exposed Donald Trump's bus scandal when he was talking about grabbing women's pussy. Then they exposed him talking on an elevator that he was gonna marry a young girl. So they've been really trying to dig a lot of dirt on him. So, and of course, you know, Donald Trump doesn't have a good relationship with most media stations because he doesn't like them that much. He always feel that they're kind of like really not nice to him, but they helped him win because, you know, Donald Trump really was the only person who was in the news so much that, you know, he had so much free publicity during his campaign because the media were always having something to talk about Trump. And this dirty dossier that was just recently exposed has of course been denied by Trump, that this really didn't happen. And he's kind of like say that people are kind of like just playing dirty games on him because they want to kind of like ruin his reputation. And he said such things didn't happen because apparently he's a germaphobe, and he said that he doesn't have any sex step in Russia. And it's kind of like really strange because you don't really know what to believe, because of course if you're one of those people who know espionage. The Russians are really good at spying on people, and you know, that's why even, you know, international leaders, when they go to Russia, they are advised to like really behave properly or be very, very careful with what they do, because the Russians government especially have the tendency to bug other leaders to kind of like, you know, spy on them for, you know, for future blackmail. And this has caused a lot of controversy, because people have also had issues with Donald Trump being friends with Vladimir Putin, who is the Russian president. You know, people always wondered why Trump has got kind of like a liking to Vladimir Putin, and people are kind of like now speculating that, oh, maybe that's why Donald Trump is kind of like a puppet to Vladimir Putin, because he has debt on him. You know, when someone has debt on you, they can use that debt to blackmail you, and they can use that, you know, against you. And of course, there's also been rumors about the Russian government's hand in, you know, forging the elections in America. So the political situation in America is really in turmoil, and to be honest, the inauguration is going to be really something interesting to watch. We are, as people who are like spectators from outside America, are just looking forward to seeing what will happen. And of course, there's been rumors of people wanting to assassinate, you know, Donald Trump. And, you know, there's been a lot of rumors going on. So for now, we just keep our fingers crossed and hope everything is going to go well. But it was really embarrassing, because also when Donald Trump held a first press conference, he refused to answer questions from the CNN reporters who were there asking questions, because he just exposed them for being fake and, you know, for spreading lies. Because apparently these news networks, which are kind of like supposed to be unbiased, didn't check the source of the story of this dossier, dirty dossier, you know, where Trump was asking prostitutes to come and pee in his bathroom. And yeah, so this is what is going on in the political arena. You guys are welcome to let me know in the comment section below, how do you think the inauguration is gonna go? Because it's already too much drama happening there as well, because no one wants to perform at the inauguration. And, you know, Michelle and Obama just made their final speech and said goodbye. And, you know, it's kind of like really interesting to see what's gonna happen with Donald Trump. Do you think Donald Trump will really be assassinated on that day, or do you think Donald Trump, they'll come up with something to impeach him and not be president of America at all? Because there's been a lot of talk and a lot of drama, so it's, everything is kind of like unveiling, and I'm kind of like really interested to see what happens. You are welcome to let me know what you think about this golden shower scandal that just happened about, you know, Donald Trump, and what you think about the inauguration. Please let me know in the comment section below, because I'll be more than happy to kind of like have a chit chat with you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, bye.